Hallelujah. How many believe it tonight?
It's your time. This is your time of salvation and restoration, your time of healing, your time of comfort. This is your destiny shaping hour. It's your time, releasing the power and the glory of God upon your life.
Praise the Lord, beloved. You're welcome to It's Your Time. My name is Apostle Mrs. Liang Kofi, and I thank God for the privilege of bringing you the Word of God. I believe this word I'm bringing to you is very pertinent in the times and seasons in which we find ourselves as a world. I'm talking about the current trend of terrorist attacks all over the world. It seems like now all over the world, people are living in fear and in torment because people are just not sure what's going to happen next. Rumors of all kinds of attacks are flying around. But I believe that in as much as different governments will raise up security on our borders and, you know, within the inland of our nation, I believe that there is a security that comes from above. That's a divine security that will cover us as a people as we seek God's face. So tonight I'm ministering a word titled Securing Your Borders. Now, if you go to the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 54, from verse 9 to 17, there's a sure word of God concerning divine protection and preservation. Listen to it. He says, "For this is as the waters of Noah unto me. For as I have sworn that the waters of Noah should no more go over the earth, so I have sworn that I will no longer be wroth with thee, nor rebuke thee. For the mountain shall depart, and the hills shall be removed. But my kindness will never depart from you, neither shall my covenant of peace be removed, saith the Lord that has mercy on you." He says, "O thou afflicted, tossed with tempest and not comforted, behold, I will lay your stones of fair colors and lay your foundations with sapphires, and I will make your windows of agates and your gates of carbuncles and all your borders of pleasant stones, and all your children shall be taught of the Lord, and great will be the peace of your children." Hallelujah. So, "And in righteousness thou shalt be established, and thou shalt be far from oppression, for you shall not fear, and from terror, for it shall not come near you." What a sweet promise of God. And he says, "Behold, they shall surely gather against thee, but not by me. Whosoever shall gather together against thee shall fall for thy sake. So behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that brings forth an instrument for his work. And I have created the waster to destroy. And I say that no weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord." Hallelujah. What beautiful words, wonderful, assuring words of God's divine protection and God's divine preservation. He says that he's the one who created the blacksmith, who forms the weapon. And it is he who has also created the one who will take the weapon to go and destroy. And he is saying that because he's in control over the one who made the weapon, as well as the one that is going to use the weapon, he is saying that no weapon formed against your life will prosper because he's in control over the one who carries the weapon, as well as one who made the weapons. Beloved, if there's security in anything, it is not in any place, not in any man, but it is in the Lord. You see, divine security is what we need in times like this. The waters of Noah that the prophet Isaiah was talking about talks about the waters of destruction. God caused waters to overflow the earth and destroy the whole earth by water. But God swore by himself afterwards that he would never cause waters to destroy the earth again. It was a plague of mass destruction. People died. But God promised that he would not destroy the earth by flood again. He didn't say by nothing else, but he says by flood again. You see, because God has the power to kill and God has the power to make alive. But the word of God in 1 Peter 1, 3 to 5 says that, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy has begotten us unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that faded not away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed at the last time. He says that we are kept by the power of God through faith. Amen. Once you are saved, there is that power of God that saved you, that also will preserve your life, that will also keep you and keep your life from destruction. We are kept by the power of God. Praise the Lord. The whole world, the whole earth belongs to him. He commanded and the earth was formed. There's nothing that was made in the earth, and indeed no man that is alive who was not created by God. And it is God who says that he is the one who also brings the counsel of the heathen to naught. That when people plan and they plot to destroy, he can bring their counsel to nothing. He said he makes the devices of the people of none effect. Praise the Lord. And so if there will be any attack against your life, if there will be any attack against us as a nation, God has the ability of forestalling that attack. And so I'm speaking to you tonight, brethren, that don't live in fear, because our God is able to protect us. Our God is able to defend us. Our God is able to keep us. Bible says, blessed is the nation whose God the Lord is, and the people that he has chosen for his own inheritance. Praise the Lord. You see, God knows his own. Bible says God knows those who are his. Amen. And God who knows those who are his will keep those who are his. Praise the Lord. Now, if you go to Psalm 33, reading from the verse 6, he says, there is no king saved by the multitude of a host. That a king is not saved by the reason of how great his army is. Amen. It says, and a mighty man is not delivered by much strength. Otherwise, Goliath would not have been killed by David. Praise the Lord. So behold, a horse is a vain thing for safety. Neither shall he deliver any by reason of his great strength. Hallelujah. That means that when we put our trust and our confidence in the things around us to save us, it is pointless. Amen. But he says, but the eye of the Lord, praise the Lord, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him. Amen. And upon them that hope in his mercy. And so when we put our trust and our confidence in the Lord's eyes will be upon us, and the Lord will protect us, and he will defend us. The psalmist in Psalm 33 verse 19 says, to deliver their souls from death and to keep them alive even in famine. Praise the Lord. So once you are looking unto God, you are trusting, you've put your trust and your confidence in God. He said he will deliver your life from death, and he will even deliver you from destruction. Praise the Lord. The horse is a vain thing for safety. So no one can be delivered by reason of the strength of his horse. Amen. A king is not saved because he has a mighty army. No, it is not the strength of your army. It is all because of the divine grace of God. See, it is the Lord that delivers from death and destruction. It is the Lord who can keep us alive. Many things today are threatening the peace of mankind. Many things are threatening the peace of the world. Terrorism, deadly diseases, unreasonable and wicked men, as the Bible has said. Deadly diseases are, you know, coming up every day. A few days ago, you know, we just heard about the Zika virus. And so many things that are popping up here and there, you know, and sometimes you just don't understand where all these things are coming from. And the thing is that sometimes it causes fear to rise up in your heart. But I preach this message to you tonight so your heart will be secured in the knowledge and in the understanding that God will keep you. Hallelujah. God will keep you. He will keep your family. He will keep you alive. Hallelujah. Today, immorality, perversion of the most outrageous types are being practiced all over the world. Our children, our homes, our marriages seem to be under threat. And the threats of these things don't have any respect for who you are. Sometimes it will shock you that despite your standing or your religious affiliation, the enemy can bring certain things right to your doorstep. You know, the devil doesn't respect whether you are great or small. Hallelujah. You see, many homes today don't have peace. Airports are no longer a secure place. Simple journeys today are no longer simple. Hallelujah. Schools are no longer safe havens. Schools are now subject to bombings and kidnappings, shootings, and gang wars. But, and that's a big but the word of God in the book of the prophet Isaiah is saying that the mountain shall depart and the hill shall be removed, but my kindness will not depart from you, neither shall my covenant of peace be removed from you, said the Lord that has mercy on you. He says that he has a covenant of peace with you, and he will not remove that covenant. Amen. That covenant will not be broken. That God says that he is your Jehovah Shalom, the one who gives you peace in the midst of the storm, the one who causes total well-being around you and your household. Praise the Lord. Now, if you go to Numbers chapter 25 from verse 1 to 13, Bible says, and Israel abode in Shittim, and the people began to commit whoredoms with the daughters of Moab, and they called the people unto the sacrifice of their gods. And the people did eat and bow down to their gods, and Israel joined himself to Baal, who was an idol. And the anger of the Lord was kindled against Israel. And the Lord said to Moses, take all the heads of the people and hang them up before the Lord against the sun, that the fierce anger of the Lord may be turned from Israel. And Moses said to the judges of Israel, slay ye every one his men that were joined to Baal. And behold, one of the children of Israel came and brought unto his brethren a Midianitish woman in the sight of Moses and in the sight of all the congregation of the children of Israel, who were weeping before the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. And when Phinehas, the son of Eleazar, the son of Aaron, the priest, saw it, he rose up from among the congregation and took a javelin in his hand. And he went after the man of Israel into the tent and thrust both them through. I mean, he stabbed the man and the woman through her belly, so that the plague that God was releasing upon the nation, because they had gone to join themselves to the daughters of Moab, were having carnal relationships with them, that plague would be stopped. Praise the Lord. And the Lord spoke unto Moses, saying that Phinehas, the son of Eleazar, the son of Aaron the priest, has turned away my wrath from the children of Israel, while he was zealous among them, that I consume not the children of Israel in my jealousy. And watch what God said he would do. He said, wherefore say, behold, I give unto him, that's Phinehas, my covenant of peace, and he shall have it, and his seed after him, even the covenant of an everlasting priesthood, because he was zealous for his God and made atonement for the children of Israel. So one man's act to really restore the peace of God unto the nation caused God's heart to be removed to establish a covenant of peace with him. And that covenant of peace would keep, he said, Phinehas and his generations. And the scripture I read to you from the book of the prophet Isaiah said he would make a covenant of peace with Phinehas and his generations after him, because he was zealous for the Lord. And that covenant of peace will go down to his generations. And that covenant of peace is the same covenant of peace that God is telling us today in the book of the prophet Isaiah, that he will not remove that covenant from us. So the plague and the terrors of the enemy will not have root in our life. But on the contrary, according to the book of the prophet Ezekiel chapter 34, verse 25, he says that he will make a covenant of peace with those whose hearts are turned towards him. And he will cause evil beasts to cease out of their land, and they will dwell safely in the wilderness and will sleep even in the woods. Praise the Lord. When God's covenant of peace is with you, he said that he will rid your land of evil beasts. He will remove evil workers, evil, unreasonable men out of your land. And he'll cause you to dwell in secure and peaceable habitations. He said, and even if you're in the wilderness, you'll be safe. and you'll be able to sleep in the woods. But beloved, you know that to sleep in the woods is not safe. But God says that when his covenant of peace is with you, you can sleep in the woods, and because of his presence, your life will be secured. You see, it's God in the midst of his people that brings that peace. Hallelujah. That covenant of peace I'm talking about is the presence of God being with us to protect us, to shield us, and to give us peace and safety and security all around us. See, God says in Zechariah 2:5 that he himself will be a wall of fire around us, and he will be the glory within our lives. Praise the Lord. So the protective covering that is around your life, that is around your family, that is around your home, is the very presence of God. He says that he will surround your life with fire. He will be like a fire around you, and his glory will shine through your life. So, beloved, there's no need to rise up in fear, and there's no need to live in terror of what's going to happen or what's not going to happen. Rather, live your life in absolute and complete trust in the Lord, knowing that he who has called you is faithful. He says, I will be a wall of fire round about you, and I'll be the glory in the midst of Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. See, there's a need for us as a people today to return to God. See, because when you are far from God, you are an open bait to the enemy. But if you are close to God, his very presence guarantees a security. The scripture I read to you tells us that when Israel joined themselves to Baal-peor and they had relationship with the Moabite women, the plague came and they were destroyed. But when Phinehas made an atonement, peace was restored to the people. You see, sin is a separating factor. Sin will separate us from God. And when we are separated from God, the enemy will have the opportunity of entering into our lives. You see, Bible says that God has built a hedge around us. But the word of God also tells that he who breaks the hedge, the serpent will bite. Amen. So it's so important that in these times of terror all around the world and earthquakes and storms and fires and all kinds of things that we hear, it's time for us to make our peace with God, to come to a place of restoration, of fellowship with God, and to have his presence with us, and that covenant of peace that God has promised restored completely unto us. Praise the Lord. So that every plague, every attack, everything that the enemy would wish to bring upon us will be averted. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. God is our hiding place. Bible says that God is our hiding place. He will preserve us from trouble. Amen. Your hiding place is not any house. It's not any bunker. It is the Lord. Hallelujah. And say he will compass us, or he will surround us with songs of deliverance. Amen. And when the Lord surrounds you, it's greater than any fortress, because he himself, he's a refuge from the storm. He's a shadow from the heat. Hallelujah. He's a fortress and he's a shield. Praise the Lord. And so if you are being frightened, if your life today is not at rest because you're afraid of who's coming into your house or who's coming with whatever, it's time to rather secure your life in the Lord. It's time to secure your borders by securing your life in your relationship with the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's time for us to mend every hedge around us. That many times by our own actions or sometimes inactions, we have broken the hedge. A lot of people break the hedge in their marriage, break the hedge in their homes. A lot of homes don't have peace, a spirit of division and fighting. And when there's division in the home, surely the enemy has one foot in it and he will enter and bring destruction. But then when there's unity, when there's love and there's joy, and the presence of God is in a home, there is the presence of God that brings security. The angels of God are ascending and descending upon your house. And beloved, there's no better secure place than that. Somebody told me a story of a man and his wife who were believing God for fruit of the womb. And they were Christians and they prayed and they prayed and they prayed. And God heard them, and God sent angels to bring the baby. The Bible says, as the angels were bringing the baby that evening, they heard the sounds of fighting from the house. S words and F words and all kinds of words coming out from the house. And you know, noises of, you know, blows, fighting. And they looked at the precious baby in their arms, and the angel said, no, surely we have the wrong address. They took the child back to the storage house in heaven. Well, this is a story somebody told me. And then after 2 years of prayer again, after they finished fighting, one day God said, but I sent a baby to this camp. Why are they still asking me for a baby? And the angel said, when you sent us, we thought we had the wrong address, because the kind of words and insults that we heard coming from the house, we didn't believe that you would actually let us send such an innocent, precious child to such an environment. Beloved, sometimes when we break the hedge in our home, break the hedge in our marriage, break the hedge around us, the enemy has occasion to come in and destroy, and we lose our place of blessing. Amen. Ecclesiastes 10:8 says, he that diggeth a pit shall fall into it, and whosoever breaks a hedge, a serpent shall bite him. See, Job had a hedge around him. In fact, Satan said that, have you not built a hedge around him, about his house and about everything that he has, and that you have blessed his work and his substance are increased in the earth? You see, but what happened with Job? He broke the hedge. How did he break the hedge? He broke his hedge by fear. Amen. He broke the hedge around him by being afraid. Proverbs 10:24 says that the fear of the wicked, it shall come upon him, but the desire of the righteous shall be granted unto him. Beloved, if you move into the mode of fear, you break the hedge. Because where there's faith, there is no fear. And where there's fear, the faith cannot also operate. Job said, the thing that I greatly feared has come upon me. He had a hedge around him. Satan said so. He acknowledged it. But Job feared, and he broke the hedge by his fear. And exactly what he feared came upon him. I come to encourage you tonight. Don't be afraid. Stop being afraid of terror. Don't be afraid of any news or any prophecies or anything that is coming from anywhere. Trust in the Lord our God, who is able to deliver us from evil, who is able to protect our lives. Praise the Lord. Who is able to keep us. Praise the Lord. Bible says that in quietness and in confidence shall be our strength. In quietness and in confidence in the Lord, we shall receive strength. So as I bring this message to a close tonight, I want you to come to a place of total confidence in the Lord, that God will deliver us as a nation. God will keep us as a people. God will keep you and your family. God will protect your life. God will preserve your lives. It shall be well with you. Bible says, say unto the righteous, it shall be well with you. This is not presumptuousness. This is not wishful thinking. It is the truth. It is the word of the living God. May your borders be secured tonight. Amen. May the borders of your home be secured tonight. The psalmist in Psalm 91 says that, because you have made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, your habitation, there shall no evil befall you. And tonight I prophesy into your life that no evil shall befall you. Hallelujah. And no plague shall come near your dwelling place. God has released, dispatched his angels to keep charge over your life. Amen. And you will not be brought under the power of any satanic influence or any attack. Your borders are secured, and your children and your family are safe under the covenant of peace that Jehovah Shalom himself has made with you. God bless you, and just continue to reconnect to God and get closer to God. That's all you need. Just get closer to God, and every fear and every anxiety and every worry will just flee away, because the power of God will overshadow you and faith will rise. God bless you, and have a great week. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, beloved, if you just listen to this message and you're not born again, you must be born again. as I preached this message, I kept on talking about the covenant of peace. You see, a covenant is a spiritually binding legal agreement between two or three parties. Now, the covenant that God has with us is through his son Jesus, through the blood of his son Jesus, that Jesus died or was crucified for our sake, that our sins may be forgiven. And anyone that accepts that atoning sacrifice becomes saved, and you come into contact or into covenant with the Lord, and you are changed from being a creature of God to becoming a son of God. Have you become a son of God, or are you just one of God's creatures? It's a choice, but I believe that tonight is a good night to make that choice. And if you want to be a son of God and not just one of God's creatures, just stretch forth your hand towards me and let us pray. Let's pray. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I believe in my heart that you are the Son of God who came to die for my sins. Jesus, I confess I'm a sinner. Forgive me of all my sins. Come into my life. Be my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Thank you, Jesus, that I'm born again. Amen. God bless you, beloved. If you just pray this prayer after me, you are born again. Find a good Bible-believing church to attend. Don't sit at home and say the TV is your church. No, it's not. Find a good Bible-believing church to be discipled. God wants not just converts. He wants disciples. If you happen to be anywhere near any of our branches, we'd love to disciple you. So join us. But those of you in the Accra, Tema area, join us this and every Monday at the M Plaza Hotel for an awesome time of fellowship. You'll be blessed. Hallelujah. God bless you. And thank you so much, all covenant partners and friends of It's Your Time and the Lord's Garden Ministry. You are wonderful people. You are great people. And your labor of loving the Lord will never be in vain. God bless you. And remember, your borders are secured. God is the strength of your life. Have a great week. Amen.
You've been watching It's Your Time with Apostle Mrs. Leanne Kofi, the General Overseer of the Lord's Garden Ministries. Join us in worship every Sunday, 8 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. at the Liberty Center of the Lord's Garden Ministries at the W.E. Du Bois Center, East Cantonments, Accra. Join us also at the Hour of Prayer Fellowship every Monday, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. at the M Plaza Hotel, Roman Ridge, Accra. You may also visit any of our branches coming up on the screen. It's Your Time is sponsored by covenant partners and friends of the Lord's Garden Ministries. To become a partner to the Lord's Garden Ministries, contact us on 0302-766-168, 0244-667-534, or 0244-156-165. How many believe it tonight?